Hello dear students, and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our point, that is what? Digestive system. Okay, in that already we have discussed about certain digestive organs. We have discussed about the buccal cavity, we have discussed about esophagus, and also we have discussed about the stomach. So today let's move for the next digestive organ, that is nothing but what? Small intestine. Okay, and it is a very important organ in the digestive process or the digestion process. Okay, so let's see the different parts or the which things are already exactly happens into the small intestine. Okay, let's see. Is the longest part of the alimentary canal. Okay, so this small intestine is the longest part of the alimentary canal. Okay, so dear student, don't get confused in the longest and the widest. Okay, so widest part of the alimentary canal is what? Stomach. While the longest part of the alimentary canal is what? Small intestine. Okay, why it is called as longest? Because it is about the 7.5 meters long. Okay, so the small intestine is about the 7.5 meters long and it's arranged in a coiled form. Here also you can see that the small intestine is arranged into the coiled form. Okay, so we cannot exactly come to know exactly what is its length, but it is about the 7.5 meters long. Okay, it is the longest organ of the alimentary canal. Okay, next one. It receives secretions from two glands, liver and pancreas. Okay, so in the beginning of our lecture we have discussed about the different glands which are associated to the digestive tract. Like, which are the associated glands? Salivary gland is there, then liver is there, and the pancreas are also there. Among that we have already discussed about the salivary gland. Okay, and this liver and the pancreas receives, or the small intestine receives the secretion from two glands, and which are that glands? Liver and pancreas. Okay, so the liver and the pancreas secreted certain types of the digestive juices which receives to the small intestine, or which comes into the small intestine. Okay, next one. Wall of the small intestine secrete digestive juices, and also we have discussed that the small intestine also secreted certain types of the digestive juices. Okay, and that digestive juices are called as what? Intestinal juices. Okay, so the wall of the small intestine secretes the digestive juices, and that juices are called as what? Intestinal juices. So up till now we have discussed here the structure of the small intestine. Okay, the small intestine receives the secretion from two glands, that are what? Liver and pancreas. And the walls of the small intestine also secreted certain digestive juices which are called as what? Intestinal juices. So here in the small intestine, the partially food get digested into the intestinal juice, into the bile juice, or into the pancreatic juice. Okay, so the partially food get mixed into the intestinal juice, bile juice, and the pancreatic juice in the small intestine, and the digestion process get finished into the small intestine. Okay, so see, first we have seen the ingestion process. Ingestion process means what? The taking food in, it is called as ingestion. When we are taking food inside, then the next process started, that is what? Digestion. Okay, so ingestion is done and the digestion is done. Where the digestion process get finished? Into the small intestine. Okay, so now let's see how exactly it happens, or the how exactly the digestion process happens in the small intestine. First one we'll discuss about the liver. So this liver is a reddish brown gland. It is the largest gland present in our body. Okay, and where it is situated? It is situated at the upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Okay, upper part of the abdomen on the right side. Okay, so here in the model also you can see that, see, this is the reddish brown gland which is called as what? Liver. So this is nothing but what? Liver, and it is the largest gland present in the human body, and it is situated at the upper side of the abdomen and to the right side. Upper side and the right side. Okay, that is the exactly exactly place where the liver is get located. Okay, next one. So which type of the juices is secreted by the liver? So the liver secrete the one type of the juice, and the name of that juice is what? Bile juice. Okay, so the liver secretes the bile juice, and that bile juice is get stored in the gallbladder. Okay, so listen student, keep in the mind, it is very important. The liver secretes the bile juice, but it doesn't store it. Okay, it only secrete it, and who store that bile juice? Gallbladder store the bile juice. Okay, so here you can see that gallbladder. Okay, it is situated at the upper position of the liver. Okay, so this bile juice secreted by the liver, but it gets stored into the gallbladder. Okay, so what is the use of this bile juice? The bile juice is helps to digest the fats. Okay, it helps to digest the fats. Okay, so whenever we are having the food, in that food the fats are also present, and that fats are present into the droplets. Okay, it is very difficult to digest it. Okay, so this bile juice helps to digest the fats. How it helps to digest the fats? They break down the droplets of the fats. Okay, and it convert into the simpler form. Okay, so in short we can say that this bile juice helps to digest the fats. Okay, the bile juice helps to digest the fats. Okay, and who secreted the bile juice? Liver. And who store the bile juice? Gallbladder. Okay, so this is all about what? Liver. Let's discuss the next gland, which is related, or which is also the part of the digestive tract, that is nothing but what? Pancreas. Okay, so pancreas is large cream color gland located below the stomach. Okay, you can see here, this is the pancreas. Okay, this section or this area, we can say this is what? Pancreas. Okay, and where it is situated? It is situated below the stomach. Okay, so the large cream color gland located below the stomach. Okay, which type of the juice it secreted? It secretes the pancreatic juice and release into intestine. Okay, so this pancreas secreted one type of the digestive juice, and the name of the digestive juice is what? Pancreatic juice. Okay, and that pancreatic juice release into intestine. Okay, next one. And this pancreatic juice helps to digest the carbohydrate and proteins. Okay, so the pancreatic juice, which is secreted by the pancreas, are useful, or they helps to digest the, or they act on carbohydrate and proteins. They act on a carbohydrate and proteins and helps to convert it into the simple and the soluble form. Okay, next one we'll discuss about the intestinal juices. Which secreted, or which organ secreted the intestinal juices? Small intestine. Okay, so the digestion complete in the small intestine. So now let's discuss about the intestinal juices. Okay, so what we are telling, that the digestion process get completed into the small intestine. Okay, so the digestion process starts from the buccal cavity. So from the buccal cavity, the partially digested food now comes into the last portion of the small intestine. Okay, or the lower part of the small intestine, and in that it get, or that partially food get react with these intestinal juices. Okay, so that partially digested food gets reacts or get mixed into the intestinal juices, and with the help of these intestinal juices, the partially food get converted into the simple and the soluble form, and at the end, though, all food materials will get digested, or the foodization process is get completes into the small intestine. Okay, so in this way, different gastric juices or different digestive juices are getting produced into the small intestine, and that is the reason the digestion process is get completes into the small intestine. Okay, so here we have discussed about the small intestine, The small intestine receives the secretion from two glands that are what? Liver and pancreas. And the walls of the small intestine also produce certain types of the digestive juices, which is called as what? Intestinal juices. Okay. So the liver secreted bile juice, which helps to digest fats. The pancreas secreted the pancreatic juice, which helps to digest carbohydrate and proteins, while intestinal juices also helps to digest the food, or also helps to convert the food into the simple and the soluble form. And in this way, the digestion processes get finished into the small intestine. Okay, so here we have completed the digestion process. The food get digested, but how the digested food get transported to the all the parts of the body, that we will see in the next video. For today, thank you. We will meet in the next video.